In this video, we solve the numerical of gas turbine. So first we understand the problem statement. A gas turbine installation work on a Breton cycle, means gas turbine is work on a Breton cycles between the temperature limits of 35 degree centigrade and 715 degree centigrade, means this is the lower temperature is given and this is the higher temperature is given. Means one is the T1, means T1 is equal to 35 degree centigrade, and this is the T3. T3 is equal to 715 degree centigrade. For the maximum work to be developed, calculate temperature at the end of compression, pressure ratio and thermal efficiency. Temperature at the end of compression means we need to calculate T2. Second, we need to calculate the pressure ratio, means Rp, that is a P2 upon P1. Okay, so in the last numericals the pressure ratio is already given. Okay, but here we need to calculate this pressure ratio, and we also need to calculate thermal efficiency. Also calculate the work ratio, means we need to calculate the WR and the power output if mass flow rate of air is 20 kg per second. Means we need to calculate the net work if we consider the mass of air, means m is equal to 20 kg per second. So first we write down this given data. So first data is given T1, that is a 35 degree centigrade. So 35 plus 273 means 308 Kelvin. Other data is given T3, 715 degree centigrade plus 273, so it is a 988 Kelvin, and this mass flow rate of the air is given, that is a 20 kg per second. Now what to calculate or what to find out? So first we need to find out T2. T2 means temperature at the end of compression. Second one is the pressure ratio Rp. Third one is the thermal efficiency. Fourth one is the work ratio. And the last one is the power output. Power output means the net work maximum. Okay. For find out the T2, this equation is used. T2 upon T1 is equal to P2 upon P1. P2 upon P1 means it is the pressure ratio raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. Okay, so when we calculate the T2, we require the pressure ratio P2 upon P1, but it is not given. Okay, so first we need to calculate this pressure ratio. So for this pressure ratio, this equation is used. Okay, so in the last 2 to 3 video, we derived these equations of this Rp. Rp is equal to T3 upon T1 raised to gamma divided by 2 gamma minus 1. Okay, for that T1 and T3 is required. So this value of T1 and T3 is given. So we are able to find out this pressure ratio. So first we find out pressure ratio. Then after we calculate this T2. Then after we find out this thermal efficiency. Thermal efficiency is 1 minus 1 upon Rp raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. We also find out thermal efficiency by using this equation, that is a net work divided by heat supply. For find out this work ratio, we use this equation, that is a 1 minus T1 upon T3. Into Rp raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. So find out this work ratio, we can also use the equation, that is a net work divided by turbine work. And the last, we find out this maximum net work. For that we use this equation, that is a MCP in bracket T1 plus T3 minus 2 in bracket T1 into T3. So first we find out this pressure ratio. Okay, so for this pressure ratio we use this equation. And equation is the T3 upon T1 raised to gamma divided by 2 gamma minus 1. So we putting this value of T3 and this T1. So value of the T3 is given 988. Value of T1 is 308. And the value of the gamma is 1.4. Okay. So in these numericals, value of gamma is not given. But the standard value of the gamma for the air is 1.4. Okay. So we consider the gamma is equal to 1.4. So we calculate and we get these answers. This pressure ratio Rp is equal to 7.688. okay, and it's a no unit because it is the pressure ratio, means it is P2 upon P1. okay, so P2 and P1 have the same unit, so it is the unit list. Now next we find out this T2 temperature. For the T2 we need to follow the isentropic compression process 1 to 2, and this equation is used. T2 upon T1 is equal to P2 upon P1 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. So P2 upon P1 is equal to this value Rp, that is a 7.688. Okay. T1 is given and the gamma is equal to 1.4, means we putting this various value, this T1 is supplied right side and the value of T1 is 308. Okay, P2 upon P1 is 7.688 and the gamma is equal to 1.4. So we calculate and we get this answer of T2, that is a 551.68 Kelvin, means after the compressions the temperature of the air is increased, means at the end or inlet of this compressor the temperature of the air is 308 and at the outlet of the compressor temperature of the air is 551.68 Kelvin. Next we calculate this thermal efficiency and we use this equation, that is a 1 minus 1 upon Rp raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. You also use this equation, thermal efficiency is equal to net work upon heat supply. Okay, for find out this net work you need to calculate this T4 by applying these types of the equations. Then after you need to find out turbine work, compression work and the heat supply. Okay, then you use these equations, but here we use directly these equations. Okay, that is a okay, and we putting this value of Rp in this equation and the gamma, and we calculate in the calculator, that is a thermal efficiency is equal to 44.16%. If you use these equations you can also get the nearly same answers. Okay, that is a 43.90 or something. So both the answers are correct. So either you use this equation or either use these equations, you get the full marks. Now before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to power plant engineering or other subject of this mechanical engineering. For power plant engineering, various link is provided in descriptions, as well as in car. For other subject, I request to visit this playlist. Now we find out this work ratio for a maximum work. For the work ratio we use this equation. Okay, so this equation we also derived. Okay, or you also use this equation, that is a net work divided by turbine work. So you are able to use any one equations. Okay, you get the same answers by using these two equations. Okay, so I use this equation. Okay, so we put the value of T1, that is a 308, value of T3 988, Rp is equal to 7.68, gamma is equal to 1.4. we simplified and calculate, then we get this answer of the work ratio, that is a 0.44. and work ratio have also no units because it is the ratio of the two work. Okay, so net work and turbine work have a same unit, so it is the unitless. Now last one is the maximum power output. So maximum power output is denoted as the W net max, and equation is MCP in bracket T1 plus T3 minus 2 under root of T1 into T3. So we putting this value of M, it is given, that is a 20. Value of CP we consider the 1. T1 is given 308, T3 is 908. Okay, and we simplified or calculate, we get this answer, that is a maximum power output is 3854.49 kilowatts. So here we calculate all this. Thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like the video, subscribe my channels, and don't forget to share with your friends.